Hey, I have a date with Sunny.
That's nice. I don't want you leaving here.
Well, okay. If you have a problem with it, why don't you just call him and take it up with him?
Sunny. Hey, just wanted to update you on the Brenda situation.
You got a lead on the Balkan?
Yeah, looks like Jerry Jackson could be involved. And given his knowledge of Port Charles, looks like Brenda's in more danger than we first thought.
Has anybody ever told you about Jerry Jackson?
Yeah, we're trying to track him down right now. Look, I'll talk to Jax. I just don't know if I trust him. He's going to want to protect his brother.
You know what? I don't like Jax, but he would never sacrifice Brenda to help Jerry or risk Carly and the kids.
No, I'm more worried that he's going to try and bypass us and do this whole thing on his own, and I get it. He wants to protect his family.
Jax has been known to try to take matters into his own hands. It never works. I mean, you saw firsthand. When he tried to bury me and save Michael, pretty much bit him in the ass.
Look, the only good thing we have going for us right now is that Jerry doesn't know he's a suspect. I'd like to keep it that way.
Well, between you and Jason, you know what you gotta do.
Yeah, in the meantime, Brenda's just, you know, she's getting more and more vulnerable.
Don't worry about Brenda, I'll take care of her.
I'm not your prisoner, you know.
This is protection, not imprisonment.
We believe Jerry Jax is working with the Balkan.
What?
Well, Jerry's done a lot of crazy things.
Yeah, well, Jax would never let Jerry hurt me, so...
Okay, Jerry's not the guy you think you know. I don't know if you know this, but he took dozens of hostages at the Metro Court. He shot Rob and he shot Max. Okay, yeah, Jax can't control his brother. Nobody can. That's why you're staying put. You're safe here, and I'll explain it. Yeah?
Yeah, I found something at my place. I think you need to see it.
Okay, I'll be right over.
What? I'll come with you?
No. You're staying here. Just stay there. Hey, yeah, it's me. Brenda needs you. Right now.
You realize what he's doing, right?
Okay, so
he's
now,
about to put us in the middle,
you know
which, in my opinion, is incredibly unfair.
You know how dangerous Jerry is. Brenda cannot leave this apartment for any reason.
The Jackal is well aware of the grave danger that Divine
I'm trusting you to keep Brenda here, no matter what she tries to pull.
I'm not going to pull anything.
Okay, I don't care if she begs or she cries or she asks you to elope.
Elope? I'm sure such a thing never occurred to the Divine One.
And don't turn your back. She'll hit you over the head.
Oh, thanks for bringing that one up. I was desperate that day. I would never hit you over the head.
The Jekyll should not fail to protect the Divine One even from herself.
Good. Don't play any games with this guy, okay?
I have plans. You see how manipulative he is?
Well, he spends a lot of time with the Valkyrie. They're the dearest of friends. And you know, the Valkyrie has come to depend on the Jekyll for quite a
while. I have a date with Sunny. And it's going to be totally fine. Because remember what we were talking about the other day? It couldn't be any safer than when I'm with Sunny.
Sadly, the Divine One could not be more wrong.
Worrying about Brenda is part of your job. It's very personal to me, but we're both aiming for the same thing, right?
Yeah, your motives are your motives. I just want to kiss the Balkan and make sure Brenda stays alive.
Well, that's what I want, too. I mean, and I don't want her to be a target, but the fact that she is for me is good because she came back here and it let us have a second chance.
I thought you didn't want to see her anymore.
I don't, well, you know, we talked and we made peace. And I know for me, it's going to be very painful to love her again, but I think it'd be more painful if I didn't see her. But you know what? Until this thing with the Balkan is over, we don't know what we're going to do next.
And she's going back to Rome or something.
Well, I know, we'll get to that when we get to that. The thing is, what you need to do is just be a good detective. I'll keep Brenda close to me with guards. I'm going to pick her up this afternoon. We're going to, you know, I'm going to be with her day and night if she lets me.
Why are you telling me all this stuff?
Why? Maybe I just want you to understand me a little more.
I understand. You and Brenda are together, and you want me to keep her safe. That about sums it up, right?
Has anyone ever told you you have very interesting taste?
No one has ever complimented my taste, I don't believe.
Oh, you're kidding. Well, I think that you're lovely to be around. You're very special.
Oh. Well, I guess I've always been acutely aware of my unique qualities, but it is really lovely to have someone else recognize.
You know, and I really do want to apologize to you about the fact that Jason and I argue all the time because I think that it's mostly my fault. I think I'm just so tired of being cooped up in this place, you know?
I can open the windows.
Oh, no. I don't think it's that kind of cooped up. You know, I really want to... You know Sonny really likes you, right?
Mr. Sir, I'm not so sure.
Oh, yeah, he really does. You know, especially when he cares very deeply about somebody, it's kind of hard for him to show his true feelings. Uh-huh. In fact, I think he's kind of intimidated by you. You want to know a secret about Sonny? He doesn't know anything about computers.
That's no secret.
He's very old school. Mm. So his whole life has been about, you know, honor and protection.
Those are admirable qualities.
Yeah, which is exactly why I will be completely safe out at lunch with him.
Aha.
I also kind of wanted to remind you that Sonny is Jason's boss. I mean, really, if you think about it for a second, who's going to try something, you know, when Sonny's sitting right there?
I'm sorry. I must deny your implied request to absent the premises. But as compensation, I've arranged for you and Mr. Sir to dine here.
Here?
Mm-hmm.
Do you cook?
Well, I've called in some assistants. Here they are.
Wow, that was cool.
Bon appetit.
Indeed.
Bonjour. Bonjour.
Hello.
Hi.
We're closed.
Hey, don't do that. We're in a recession. My friend here is a one-man stimulus package.
Don't want his money.
Okay, well, that means I don't want to spend my money here then.
I don't blame you. Hold on. You don't chase off the high rollers.
He's a plague on the Quartermains.
I got nothing against your little tune of a family.
You've gotten rid of most of them. The ones that aren't dead have left town to avoid your influence.
Right now they're trying to avoid my influence.
You think that's funny?
He said it. I didn't.
Luke, did you notice the house at Thanksgiving? They were mostly your family, not mine. So here's the deal. Stay away from my family. My father is an old man. He can't take losing anybody else because of you.
So you're married, huh? Congratulations.
Yeah, I'm getting married, yeah. So, what brings you here?
I wanted to bring a date here. Because I know but security requirements, I'll probably have to buy out, you know, the place.
Same price?
Yeah, same price.
Well, then it's yours.
Good.
This date.
Yeah.
Would it be,
Brenda.
Huh. That's what I figured.
Yeah.
Good luck.
You think I'm gonna need it? You know I gave up on Brenda and me a long time ago.
Didn't seem to work.
Well, I just never thought that I'd hear from her again.
Well, that's the thing about shark attacks. You never see them coming.
I think the great white just left the building.
Touché. Well, I'm swimming after that one, to tell you the truth, and I'm prepared to live with the damage. Can you say the same?
I just get this feeling that I need to give it one last shot.
Till next time. See, pal, that's the thing about difficult women. They're the most worth fighting for. If they don't kill you on the way to happily ever after.
And you don't believe in happily ever after?
No, I don't. It's just a figure of speech, like checks in the mail or... Watch out, that's my car you're taking.
Hold on a second.
Yeah.
Hello?
Hey, where are you?
I'm making arrangements at the Haunted Star so we can, you know, be together, just the two of us.
All right, well, have you spoken to Jason? Because he says I can't leave the penthouse.
What?
You going to a funeral?
Not that I know of. Welcome to the cuisine of France.
Yeah,
in the style of
Dieu. Pick it up, Miss Barrett.
Well, she is upstairs getting ready, and you will be dining here.
I know we will not.
Stone Cold's orders were very specific.
I don't need Jason's permission to go on a date. You understand?
Hey.
Hey.
Mr. Sir appears to be unaware of Stone Cold's edict that the Divine One is not to leave the premises for her
is
own
he still
safety.
Here?
Are you okay with us staying?
No, I'm not. Let's
okay,
go.
I apologize, but I cannot let you leave the premises.
Okay. Get out of the way. Oh. What's going on here?
We're sorry, boss. We can't let the lady leave. We're under orders.
Is this a mutiny?
No, it's a brasserie. It's French.
That's good.
Boss, can just hang out, relax. Milo and I worked really hard on this.
Okay, you love your jobs, right? You want to get fired?
Please just try the first course. Max and I worked so hard.
That smell nice.
We've selected an excellent Sauvignon Blanc from the Loire Valley to complement our soup course. It is known to be crisp, clean, and slightly fruity.
Thank you, Spinelli.
It's ridiculous because Max can't even boil water for pasta.
Well, your projectors of the night have been studying the culinary arts as of late.
That's lovely. Do you like it?
Not bad.
This is actually reminding me of our first date, you know, when you told me you were going to take me to the best restaurant in town.
Yeah, I was arrogant.
You were actually right. You were arrogant, but right. A lot of the time, you know, all those years I was in Rome, I never found a red sauce quite like yours.
I was inspired.
You know what I really loved about your old apartment? You always had this incredible lighting. Everybody looked great.
Yeah.
And you had, the music was always like perfect, the music.
You were breathtaking. And I used to wonder, like, why would she like somebody like me?
May we present an heirloom tomato bisque with leeks, thyme, and roasted garlic? I roasted the garlic myself.
Oh, thanks.
Also, it's non-dairy, so as not to make either of you, gassy.
Oh, that's reassuring.
Wow. Taste that.
Sorry.